U.S. tax reform is clearing last hurdle, Trump takes aim at welfare state. Trump takes aim at welfare state. With a return of over 1.46 million jobs and the lowest unemployment rate since 1973, excuses are running out for those who are able-bodied but choose not to work. This is the target of President Donald Trump's latest political move. Trump took aim at the welfare system last week while making remarks about tax reform in Missouri. "Then we will have done tax cuts, the biggest in history, health care, phenomenal health care. I know you don't want this welfare reform. Does anyone want welfare reform?" Trump asked the crowd. "We talk to people. I know people that work three jobs and they live next to somebody who doesn't work at all," the president continued. "And the person who is not working at all and has no intention of working at all is making more money and doing better than the person that is working his and her off. And it is not going to happen. Not going to happen." Every conservative knows welfare dependence is a blight on America. Statistics show that over a third of Americans are on some form of government assistance. Those numbers shouldn't shock you. After all, we had two consecutive terms of Barack Obama, who actively encouraged families to sign up for government programs providing food, medical care, and even cell phones. Excluding both Social Security and Medicare, the U.S. taxpayer foots the bill for $717 billion in these free programs. Since 1964, Americans have been burdened with the consequences of out-of-control welfare spending. The costs have skyrocketed as the programs evolved from basic assistance to an outright way of life for entire generations. Simple food programs have taken on monstrous new forms, offering free housing and cell phones. What was once billed as a way to help your fellow citizen has turned into an outright bribe for votes. In fact, up to 13% of taxes taken out of the average paycheck fund so-called safety net programs. Fraud is common, but according to how the government measures it, only 8% of payments are considered illegal. Actual studies indicate that up to 30 out of 34 welfare recipients admit to fraud. Democrats often use SNAP, Section 8, Medicaid, and others to garner votes. By simply hinting the programs will disappear the second the Republican takes office, they now have a dedicated and fervent base, happily willing to trade a vote for their work-free food, housing, and phones. Bernie Sanders is considered the pinnacle of the free way of thinking. Is it any wonder why his voter base was motivated solely by one of the worst four-letter words to enter American politics? Donald Trump was a businessman before entering politics. Unlike most inhabitants of the Washington, D.C. swamp, he knows not only what it means to work, but also the cost a lazy and unmotivated workforce would take on a company. Running a country with a businessman's mindset has now become essential in battling the structure that Washington has built. After taking a long look at American society, Trump knows the only inequality is people who don't work, getting rich off those who do. The solution is one you won't hear from many politicians. Most are not willing to risk the votes it will cost them to get rid of bloated welfare programs in America. Trump has no such ambitions, and is here to make America great again, not to start a career. The massive support for Trump came in part from those who have had to sacrifice money from their paychecks so lazy neighbors could buy steak, lobster, candy, and soda with an EBT card. By being the only candidate willing to take such a hardline stance against welfare, Trump was able to flip historically blue states that lost jobs, industry, and money under Obama. Voters tired of suffering while others chose not to work and live high on the hog went to the polls, voting for a man they trusted would fix it. Now that tax reform is headed for success, Trump has the political capital and momentum to begin the crusade on the welfare state. These won't be minor changes. Instead, they are expected to be part of a broad order curtailing and overhauling dozens, or maybe even all, of the federal programs bleeding the treasury. Welfare was never billed as a way of life. This has not stopped states like Obama's own Hawaii from offering over $49,000 a year so people can live comfortably, courtesy of the American taxpayer. Share this story on Facebook and let us know if you think Donald Trump will be able to reform welfare with a stubborn Congress. What do you think of Trump's job as president so far? Scroll down to comment below.